What's good, everybody? This is John Jake Gaming on the mic here, and we're coming at you with a special episode of the Memphis Dynasty here on NCAA 2012. We got a fantastic rivalry game on our hands as we come in undefeated, but we go and take on a hated rival in the Black and Blue Bowl. We take on Southern Miss, who, what if we lost their first game right before we were able to step on the field against them? So I thought we were going to have this really big visit day. We were going to have our top 25 team on our field. And that's not going to be the case. That is not going to be the case, but still a big game for us as we're already just one win away from bowl eligibility already. So it should be a good one. Make sure you go ahead and smack that like button. Hit that subscribe button as well if you do have to be brand new to the channel. And real quick, I did want to say that this was the first video recorded right after what happened on Monday Night Football with DeMar Hamlin. So, you know, DeMar Hamlin, I know you and your family members will probably not watch this video, but we are thinking about you as well as many of the other members of this football community that we know and love. But with that being said, we'll be back with some football action here as we'll jump into a 3rd and 12. Going to try to pick up a first down through the air. We go with a halfback screen, and William Jones gets loose with it and picks up a really big first down. As now the Memphis Tigers are going to be driving downfield, off to a good start, looking over to right inside, and Chris Washington almost hauls it in. But it is going to go as an incompletion. It's now 3rd and 11 now. Richard's going to face some pressure. We had our tight end, Brian the Kid, wide but naked open. But we do have to settle for a field goal, unfortunately. 4th and 11. So that will set up the kick. And that kick is going to be up. And that kick will be good. So we do at least get some points on our opening drive to start this game out, but we don't get that touchdown that we were looking for. We still hold that 3-0 lead. So now, 1st and 10 for Southern Miss. Golden Eagles as they'll throw to the right-hand side. Nice hit by Zach Scott, able to make the open field tackle. It creates a 3rd and long. As now, shotgun formation, Coker. He's going to move to the right-hand side. Vince Tate's got him. Looking over to the left-hand side. It's a screen. We miss a tackle in the open field. And now he's going to be off to the races. Can Tommy Myers catch up in time? And he cannot. Touchdown, Southern Miss. And the Golden Eagles, they will take the lead here in the Black and Blue Bowl. And that is a tough one. We had them back behind that first down marker. We should be talking about getting him off the field. Instead, it is now Southern Miss that's got a lead now, as we got 2 minutes left to play here in the first quarter as we try to respond back. Looking over to the left-hand side, James Pittman, he's out in open space. No one was covering him in the secondary, and Jesse Richards is going to take advantage of that. That's a touchdown for your Memphis Tigers. And they will go ahead and retake that lead. Let's go. You absolutely love to see that. And that is actually going to wrap up the first quarter of action. It's been an exciting little first quarter of action. We're up 10-7. Should be setting up yet another classic here in this rivalry game. We'll see what the rest holds for us. So we actually jump late into the second quarter, because the first 6 minutes of this second quarter, nobody gets a first down or, you know, even turns the ball over. So nothing crazy. And y'all know how I like to do things around here, man. I do not like to show, you know, like little like 2-3 yard gains, especially if there's no first downs that come from an either. You know, that's just not entertaining to you guys, in my opinion. So that being said, Southern Miss is trying to put together a drive, but we will ironically beat them back to where that first down marker originally was. And Davis is going to be able to bring him down for a huge tackle. Is now second and 19 coming up. We will see if his quarterback line up in the shotgun. Looks over the middle and does find his receiver. He does manage to go ahead and pick up a few yards there on that play. But still a third and long. We'll see how Southern Miss tries to attack it. We will send the blitz. Looking to send five guys. That's enough to make a heck of a burger. But can it be enough to make a stop? And it does! Julian Jackson is going to knock that ball loose at the right time. And they're going to try a really long field goal. Oh my goodness, that is more than 60 yards that they tried to do. And no surprises there. That's going to be not good. So that was really the only notable drive that happened. Memphis does not get any drives in the second quarter that result in a first down. So good job by our defense there to keep us in this game. And already we find ourselves in the second half of action. Still holding on to that 10-7 lead, but Southern Miss, they will start with the football here to begin the second half. And they start with a slant pattern, and Tommy Myers has to come in and make the tackle. Zach Scott was the original defender that missed there. And now it's another first and 10, and Southern Miss, they're going to be on the move right away. Quarterback's going to look towards the sideline to get the play call. It's going to be free wide to the right, looking over to the tight end. And that tight end is going to make a good gain there. 8 yards on that one. And it's now going to be second and short. Looking. Going to be over to the left-hand side. Got it out on the perimeter. Got some space. Jackson. Can he bring him down? He can't. But thankfully, we get some help from John Curtis. That was almost a house call that we witnessed there. Thankfully, that was not what we had to see. And we still have a chance to keep this game tied. Second and goal. A couple plays later after a big reception over the middle. As quarterback will look over on the slip pattern. Hit its cons. Touchdown, Southern Miss. And the Golden Eagles are going to tank their very first lead of this football game. And it's desperate that we need to come out and get a quick response. First and 10. After the touchdown by Southern Miss. Looking over the right-hand side. It's a tight throw. But the backup fullback is going to come down and make this catch. I do not know how we got that catch. But I'm certainly glad that we did there. I'll tell you what. But we're going to need some more magic though. Third and 9. Outside of midfield. Looking over the left-hand side. Trying to get the ball out quickly. But that will also be incomplete. So that did force us to punt the football back over to Southern Miss. And Southern Miss, oh, Bowen gets the ball. It was fumbled on the ground. And Memphis is going to recover. Big time fumble as the Memphis Tigers get their hands on it. And that is Coleman that keeps him up long enough so that his teammate can come in and make the play on the football. Just a savvy play. And you want to speak about that savvy play by both sides of the ball. Anthony Douglas fits that mold as right off of the touchdown. Anthony Douglas, he's going to dive into the end zone. And the Memphis Tigers are going to be taking that lead. So now 14 to 17, we do have the lead right back. And Southern Miss will take right back over. But one thing that I did notice that in the second half, That tackling has been a little bit of an issue. Not really what I've wanted to see, but something that I've been forced to see thus far. As now, first and 10, Southern Miss. They will go into their no huddle. Dropping back, looks over the middle, but it's going to be deflected away. Nice play there by our linebacking core. And now it's going to be second and 10. Southern Miss, they will pass the football once again. They've had some success this time, dumping it off over the middle of the field. It goes for a gain of 6 yards on the play. And now it's a third and 4. Dropping back, looking. He's going to throw over to the left-hand side, and it's going to be caught. Singletary makes the catch again. It's now going to be yet another first down. Can Southern Miss repeat their success on third down, though? This time, third and long. All day to throw the football. And one of your guys' customs, he's going to make a play on the ball. The true freshman, Seth Randolph, is going to get his paws on the ball. And now Memphis is set up really beautifully there. A chance to extend this lead even further. Third and two coming up. So a short third down conversion on our hands. We're going to look at William Jones as they send the blitz up the middle. We're looking over the right hand side, though. It's Anthony Douglas. He is all by himself. He is wide, but naked open as well. And now we got a chance to punch it into the end zone and have our biggest lead of the day. First and goal, but we threw behind. Looking for Chris Washington. Should have made that throw. And instead, it's going to be third and goal. Going to get a little bit tricky now. Going to hand the ball off to Anthony Douglas. And the defense cannot rally fast enough. Anthony Douglas finds his way into the end zone. And Memphis gets yet another touchdown on that board. And it's 24-14. So now we have yet another run up the left-hand side that is going to go for a gain of 6 on the play. And that will make it 2nd and 4 for Southern Miss. Goes into the no huddle once again. Throwing over the right-hand side. Trying to throw it in the direction of Zach Scott. But that will be incomplete. So again, a 3rd and short coming up here for the Southern Miss Golden Eagles. As they'll drop back again. Looking over the left-hand side. It's going to be caught for a massive gain. How do we have that kind of defensive breakdown? I have absolutely no idea. But you know what they do got going on? They got them keys out because they got a drive going right now. We're going to finish it off, though. 3rd and 10. And Tommy John Curtis had the balls in his hands but cannot corral it in. So Southern Miss, they have to settle for a field goal. This would make it a one-possession game, but it hooks to the right. And that field goal attempt, actually, is not going to be good. They miss the field goal there. So now our offense will come back out onto the field. Got a 3rd and 9 coming for our squad. See how we can attack this drive. It's Richards. Looks to the right-hand side. Finds James Pittman down the sideline. Cannot pull away. That pullout game was weak. But he did pull that one in, though. And a critical third down conversion there, too. As Jesse Richards, he was facing some serious heat as well. Nice job staying composed in the pocket. So now, after the big conversion, 1st and 10, we try to throw to the right-hand side to shut up that halfback screen. As we know, Southern Miss has been bringing quite a bit of pressure as of late. But that does not work out in our favor, though, as that will be incomplete as well. And that's going to be the end of your third quarter. We're up by 10 with a chance to win this Black and Blues Bowl game again. Let's see if we can finish it off. One more quarter left to play. We're going to run up the middle of the field. It's Matt Turner, the backup running back who checks into the game and gets his first carry in this one. He gets a critical first down. You absolutely love to see it. And we'll see if we can continue that rhythm. 1st and 10, looking over to right-hand side, trying to get it out to that curl route a little bit early, that corner route. But that is incomplete, though, as we'll keep it on the ground again. 2nd and 10, Matt Turner got a big hole up the middle of the field. And, oh, my center really needs to get that block. If he gets that block, that's a touchdown. That is an absolute guarantee there. Instead, it's 3rd and 2. Richards going to try to throw for the first down. Gets it to Chris Washington, and they don't give him the touchdown. But we will end up getting that first down, though, and a chance to extend the lead with Anthony Douglas, who runs it in again. He's just having himself a day. Multiple rushing touchdowns and also a receiving touchdown to his name as well. So our biggest lead of this entire game just got even bigger. We are up by 17 points right now. It's looking good for our squad at the moment, but we gotta finish it off. 1st and 10, looking over the right hand side, and it's gonna be broken up. Nice job jarring that ball loose. It eventually leads to yet another third and long for Southern Miss. Looks like I got a four wide set here. Play action, dropping back over the right hand side, and it's gonna be completed. Southern Miss gets the first down that they needed, and they're on the move using that vaunted no huddle offense. Our defense could barely get set before the next play starts, and it shows as we definitely had some confusion there. And I was actually really surprised that we did not have a offsides penalty. But what we will end up seeing, though, is another offsides happen on the very next play. They're going to call it on one of the offensive line for Southern Miss, and that will move them back a few yards. So that's going to make it a longer first down that they'll need to convert on, first and 15. Following the penalty, though, Southern Miss, their quarterback, gets plenty of time. They're going to watch this ball all the way downfield, and Julian Jackson comes in at the last moment to deflect that pass away. That could have very well gone for a touchdown if Jackson was just another step slow. So now, second and 15 instead, looking over to the right-hand side, a little bit of a crossing pattern, but after a broken tackle, it goes for a significant 13-yard gain, and Southern Miss once again going no huddle, trying to see if they can catch us off guard, but our defense is ready, as I thought we saw a little bit of a false start, but our defense is still going to hold up nonetheless. Fourth down coming up, and Southern Miss, of course, is going to go for this. They have no choice at this point. Fourth and one, dropping back over the middle of the field, and it's going to be caught over the middle, and Zach Scott will make that tackle once again, but another blown coverage, which now makes it first and 10. Defense again, almost getting caught off sides! That should have been intercepted. We let him get away with one, and it keeps Southern Miss alive, although not much breathing room to make a mistake. They have to score a touchdown still. Can they make it happen on this drive? Second and goal. It's going to be a speed option to the right hand side. The pitch, it's out there, and it's going to be in the end zone, and it's a touchdown for Southern Miss. So they do go for the onside recovery. They fail, but we cannot run the rest of this clock out. We do get a field goal up on the board, though. But Southern Miss, they still have a couple of their timeouts. So they can score really quickly without using any of their timeouts. This game is far from over. And that is what is you get with the drama of a rivalry game, especially in conference play. None of the less, it is certainly something else right now. We could be in for a dramatic finish. We get caught offside, so a quick throw to the left-hand side is incomplete. But it won't even matter, though, because that offside was as clear as day. No official would even miss that call, and there's certainly some blind refs out there. Let's keep it real. And now it's first and five as they'll look over to the right-hand side, trying to throw towards the end zone, but that will be incomplete. So Smith will go ahead and run it back here. Second and five. As we'll send our freshman corner, Seth Rudolph, on the blitz. Gotta use your custom. Show a little bit of love. But our defense is not showing us much love right now. We are getting clobbered here in this fourth quarter. And Summer Miss, all of a sudden, with a chance to make this just a one-possession game in the final minute of action. Third and goal. Smith lines his guys up in a goal line set. He's going to run it up the middle with his tailback, but his tailback falls forward. And Southern Miss gets a touchdown on the board again. And with the extra point, they're only down by a one possession. Southern Miss, though, they do need this onside recovery to keep the game alive. And it was a pretty solid kick. But unfortunately, though, it's going to be kicked out of bounds. And just, it was a dramatic finish. Don't get me wrong. A little bit more for my blood pressure than what I really wanted. But that being said, though, we do come through, and we will still be undefeated on the season so far. 34-28, that will end up being your final score. Great win for our program as we beat our hated rivals for the second time in two seasons. So, man, we may have won this game, but not gonna lie, we kind of struggled to move this football today. Jesse Richards was not on it today. He was only 12 for 34, 190 yards, and two touchdowns in the game. Even our ground game really couldn't get much going on the ground, but Anthony Douglas, though, did get a couple of touchdown runs, so I do love to see that. But he did have negative yards rushing, so that kind of sucked. Running game really was non-existent, to be honest. But for our receivers, you know, our receivers, they did come in. They made plays when we really needed the plays to happen. Anthony Douglas had one of our touchdown grabs. It's his only second game of the season. He had free catch for 24 yards and a score. And then James Pittman had our biggest game of the entire game. He had a 60-yard touchdown. That happened in, I think it was the first quarter of this game. Now, defensively, our defense is really what the star of the show was. They gave up a little bit more in the second half, but they held firm. Vince Tate led the team in tackles today. He had six tackles, two TFLs, and a sack in this one. Also getting some good solo tackles in is Julian Jackson, Rocky Scott, and Tommy Myers as well coming in the run support. Speaking of providing that support, we got to this quarterback quite a few times today. Six sacks. Matter of fact, at the very least, Robin Bowen actually led the team in sacks, so both of his tackles were sacks, and then Nate Coleman, Tommy Myers, Vince Tate, and Kyle Davis were all able to get to the quarterback, and I thought I saw some half sacks in there. I thought we saw a little tag team in the game, but, you know, maybe my eyes deceived me. No one had more than a, half sack error than who I just talked about, but play of the game, potentially, Seth Randolph. He's a true freshman. Haven't really seen his name all year long. He makes a huge play in the rivalry game. He only had one tackle in this one, but he also had an interception that he almost took to the crib, and that set up a touchdown drive. Nate Coleman also set up a touchdown drive as well. We had three turnovers in this game. Robert Bowen recovered a fumble, and then Rocky Scott also recovered a fumble as well. And that was really the difference. Those turnovers, we weren't pretty on offense, but well, we kept it clean on our side of the ball. Well, we turned the ball over three times with our defense. That was the ultimate difference here in the black and blue Bones game. All right, boys, so not only do we get some wins on the football field, we also got some dubs in recruiting as well, as our recruiting is really starting to bear fruit. We get a few guys that I really wanted. Most importantly, we get David Kraft. He's a three-star defensive lineman from Winsburg, Tennessee, and we're going to keep him in the state of Tennessee. He signs with your Memphis Tigers, so I'm real excited to bring him into the program. But we do also sign a couple of two-star guys as well. Ed Stanley also is going to sign on the dotted line. He's a two-star free safety. And then we also sign the two-star Grant Copeland from Parkwood, North Carolina. He also signs with the program as well, but it's not all perfect, though. We do lose out on a couple of guys that I also wanted to bring in. Brad McGee, he does end up signing for Mid-Tennessee State. He was also a three-star defensive end. And then the three-star corner that I was going after, Chris Whitmore, we actually cannot keep him in the state of Tennessee. He is going to play in the MAC Conference and is going to play his college football with the Ohio Bobcats. So here we are at 6-0, and I'm actually really surprised we are not ranked in the top 25. So one thing that I was pretty interested in is I wanted to see if, you know, not only are we getting any top 25 votes, is there anyone in Conference USA that is in the top 25? I know we had this last year. Southern Miss was in here earlier this year, and it looks like there is nobody in the AP top 25 for Conference USA. And not only that, the only school that's in the Conference USA is UCF, and I think Tulsa might still be in Conference USA, but I don't 100% remember, to be honest with you. We're still not receiving votes anymore. So here we are at 6-0, and we still do not have any respect from the national media. And you know what that means. We're going to have to take that out on UAB in the next episode. Could make this a doubleheader. Don't be surprised if this is a doubleheader because they are winless, but we do have to go on the road. So You never know how things can go going on the road, and this is still a rivalry game for us here, so you know we got to get this win no matter what. So all things being considered, I hope you enjoyed today's episode of the Memphis Dynasty, and if you did, make sure you go ahead, smack that like button for me, hit that subscribe button as well if you do happen to be brand new to the channel. This is John J. Gaming on the mic signing off, but I'm hoping you're out here having a good one. Take care, everybody.